If you feel like you deserve a raise and you feel like you've been doing appreciate people that you see working, because there's a lot of people that's not working, and the people that are working are being a service to us. So appreciate them. So during this time, yeah, you asked for a raise or a better position. How about that? Try to get some face time with the big boss or ask someone out on a date. Good luck. Oh my God, you can put it on a little piece of paper and slide it to them. You know what I mean? Unless you know you got a lot of confidence, girl. Yeah. Okay. Try to get some FaceTime with the big boss or ask someone out on a date. You'll give off an unmaskable air of confidence. Okay. But what happens if they say no? Are you going to still feel confident? I'm just saying. Make sure you kind of feel like, I don't know, child. I don't know. I don't know about that one. But you know, if you've been feeling a person for a long time and you kind of seen them scoping you out, yeah, ask them out on a date. I know one time I was working, and this young guy that I ended up dating somebody younger than myself. It didn't last long. We ended up becoming best friends. But he was watching me. We was working at like a place where you call freaking people and try to sell them stuff, like magazines, like telemarketing, right? And he was on the booth that way. And I was like, my back was actually facing him. But every time I go to turn around to go get up to use the bathroom, he like this. And I'm like, okay. I try to pay him no mind. And then I come out the bathroom and he bump into me. And then one day, I left work, getting in my car. He was outside, parked by my car. And said, hey, you want to go to IHOP? Yeah, I want some pancakes. He was cute too. We end up dating. I thought I would never date young. I dated young, y'all. How old was I? Yeah, I had about 12 years. About 12 years. He was fine. Anyway, that's another story. Okay, let's get back to this. Try to get some FaceTime with the boss or ask someone out on a date. You'll give off an unmistakable air of confidence, which might be a bit stronger than what you actually feel. This level of boldness could open up some very important doors for you. Right now, child. Okay, now, you know what? Sometimes there's just a small window for an opportunity, and you don't take it at that moment. It's gone. It may not come back around. So they said, go for it. Okay. All right. I like Aquarius. That was pretty cute. All right. Let's go to the next one. Child, my mother's a Pisces. My mother's a Pisces. I'm going to be in her business today a little bit. I'm just saying. That's the only Pisces. I never met another Pisces ever in my life. Ever nobody. If y'all are Pisces, tell me y'all are Pisces, okay? Let me know if y'all are Pisces, because I ain't never met no Pisces but my mother, you know? And the one thing I do know is that she's funny. She's silly. She's smart. She's street smart. You won't know she broke, because she know how to carry herself. She know how to hold herself in a public, you know, around society or whatever. She will fight you, and she will talk about you in your face, and she will use you, and she won't pay you back, and tell you she ain't gonna pay you back. I'm just saying, I ain't saying all Pisces like that. I'm just saying, I know. Okay, y'all. Finding a balance between what you want and what is best for everyone involved is important today. Before making any decisions, you have to factor in other people's feelings and goals. Do you see what I'm talking about? Do you see this? I gotta see this, but I won't see it because I don't know no Pisces, but that's a good one. Let me read that again. Before making any decisions, you have to factor in other people's feelings. intuition is strong and you can sense what people want. Don't bend too far backwards to accommodate them, though. They said don't bend too far backwards to accommodate people. Most Pisces, or well, I don't know most Pisces, but my mother, she ain't gonna bend but so far, period. Period, okay? You better, like, literally, child. Nope, okay? She not gonna bend but so far. And then, but it says don't bend far backwards to accommodate them, though. Just let them know you consider their feelings. And that's plenty of incentive, child. Oh, my God. Okay, y'all, let's move on from the feisty. So, you better come correct with the feisty or your feelings gonna be hurt. I'm just saying. Okay, Aries. Okay, Aries. March 21st, April 19th. Let's go off the details today. You have to face the fact that not every single one of them is going to line up nicely and neatly for you. Don't take it personal. I'm just reading. Good news is your overall plan will work out quite well. It won't be perfect, but what is, you have to let go of the of that ideal. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just saying. I don't always say, well, I think, like you say something, well, I feel, but I think, you know, because they're going to correct you. And they're going to tell you how they feel and what they think it is. And if it's your opinion, they're going to let you know your opinion not correct. They're going to explain to you what it is, okay? You have to let go of that ideal. It will only stress you out and make you miss the chance to feel proud of yourself. Wow. And a lot of Aries are very smart and they write a lot. So when they tell you off, you're going to get a 5-page letter. I'm just saying. It will get a lot more accomplished if you just accept things the way they are and start working with what you have. Period. I like that one. Yes, that's a good one. Because there's some things we can't change, but sometimes we're so focused on everything else that's going on that we can't even see what's right in front of us that we could work with. The next one is Taurus, child. Taurus the Bull. And I know a couple of Tauruses. Matter of fact, the young guy that I dated was a Taurus. Okay. Aquarius from January 20th. Wait a minute, I just read that one. Why is it coming back up? Child. Taurus. There it go. And we all know my son is a Taurus, okay? We all know Dream is a Taurus. You are not exactly lazy. Not lazy. They mostly like, the word is not reserved. They kind of like, it's not really laid back, but they kind of like, they go in things, observing everything. You know what I mean? And it kind of moves slow because they watch it. Everything. They very observant. But you're not exactly motivated either, child. Okay, this just for today. Don't take it personally. A lot of times I be feeling like, what's going on with you? What's going on with you? And actually, it may not seem like he's motivated, but he's always working on something. And it takes time for his project that he put together because it has to be perfect. And then when he finished with his project, it's like shocking. Most of the time, Tauruses don't let people know what they got going on. I'm just saying, so you don't really see what they doing. That's why he moved out. This is probably due to a perceived lack of excitement in today's activity. But what you might think sounds boring could actually turn into a total enthralling. Enthralling. I never heard that word. Look it up. Let me know in the comments what it is. It's enthralling. I never heard of that. If you open your mind to it, plaster a smile on your face and tell yourself that this is going to be fun. It's not about lying to yourself. It's about expecting the best. that's the Taurus. Gemini. I got a few Geminis that I know. I have two sisters that are Geminis, and I have a grandbaby that's Gemini. And I think I have a spirit-a-light that's a Gemini. I don't know. I don't know if she's between Gemini and Cancer. But yeah, take care of yourself. Could start to overwhelm you if this relationship brings up some bad or confusing memories. Step back and give yourself space to think things through. Don't worry about hurting the other person or spoiling the momentum. That stuff just doesn't matter as much as your comfort and safety. Gemini, take care of yourself and take care of your feelings, because I know a lot of times people tend to think it's easy to hurt a Gemini's feeling, because a lot of times they just the most sweetest people. Cancer. So we all know Nadine's a Cancer. I think Sarah's a Cancer. Who else a Cancer? Tamara is a Cancer. Is it Tamara? Is it, anyway, I got a few spirit-a-lights that are Cancers this year, like the same birthday as Nadine, or their birthday is close to Nadine, or they're Cancer like Nadine. I got two Cancers too. Both my daughters are Cancers. They're totally different. So they might have like different suns and different moons. And I just found out about that stuff through Sarah, like a child. Don't ask me, okay? It's natural to compare yourself to other people, but there really is no comparison, child. I feel like Cancers are like, they're special. You have your own unique personality. So what if you're not every person cup of tea? I know that's right. I know that's right. All that matters is that the people who get you are the people who want to be around you. Please stop wasting your energy trying to impress someone who just isn't worth it. Watch out for others who want to change you. I know. Yes. I love that one for Cancer. I absolutely love that one. Okay, Leo. Leo in the house. Okay. Let's see what Leo's talking about from July 23rd to August 22nd. It's a parent child. Y'all know what? I just made it for Leo. I told y'all. A lot of people say, you don't seem like a Leo. I'm more like a Cancer, because I just made it to be a Leo. I just made it, okay? But I am a Leo, and I always let people know, look, I'm a Leo, you know, because I know sometimes people meet Leos and they start backing off, but I'm the Leo that's in more of the Cancer realm, so I'm pretty cool. I'm pretty, you know, I ain't gonna just jump in, be all up in your face, rah. I know a lot of Leos that like to be rah. Sit back and watch, and if I feel like something ain't right, then you're probably not even gonna feel me snatch. But anyway, I'm one of the very calm. I feel like I'm a calm Leo until you make me upset. But anyway, Leo, from July 23rd to August 22nd, is a parent or coach just not giving you the tough love you're looking for. boss would give you more positive rather than negative reinforcement. Yes, yes, that's a good one. Looking for a little bit more affection from your sweetie. I would like that affection from somebody, but I haven't met him yet. If you want your needs to be met by others, you need to do them a favor and let them know. Let them know what you want. Okay, I like it. I like it. People can't read your mind. You have the diplomatic skills to say what you want without sounding demanding. They say they're throwing a little shade. We're not demanding. We just want you to do what we say do. Just kidding. Okay, that was one for Leo. That was cute. Okay. Virgo. Hey, Virgos. I love Virgos. Virgos are so freaking just, what's the word for them? They laid back. Of being on autopilot right now. You got your routine. You know how to do things and you know how you like them done. Now what? Oh, with a question mark. Now what? Oh, let me read that again. You got your routine. You know how to do things and you know how you like them done. Now what? So get it done. Get it done. You need to infuse a bit of freshness into your life. To do this, start talking to new people. Yes, and that's another thing. They definitely like this circle, and they don't like this circle to change. Get conversational going. You'll meet someone who teaches you something and change one of your opinions. Oh, wow. They definitely stuck on their opinion. Definitely. There's an opportunity to expand your mind every day if you choose to open yourself up to it. Oh, wow. Wow, that's a good one, Virgo. That's a good one. I got a personal story to that, but this is not time, place to do it, so I won't. Maybe another time. Libra. My dad is a Libra, and my son, rest in peace, is a Libra. A ton of romantic energy is flying around today, but you will really have enough time to take advantage of it. As much as you like to do, you can spend all day flirting with people. You have to focus on your work. Oh, okay. Yeah, I said you can't. It says you can't spend all day flirting with people. You have to focus on work now. Fun comes later. Trying to force the two together is only going to make you fail at both. So prioritize appropriately, get the boring stuff out of the way early, and then devote the rest of your day to pleasant pursuit. Oh, that's nice for Libras. I like that. Scorpio. Okay, Scorpio. October 23rd to November 21st. That means one of my sisters is a Libra. No. It's her birthday the 28th. Nope, she's a Scorpio, y'all. I think her birthday the 28th. Anyway, I thought I was going to say she's a Libra. You just learned some critical information. You are standing on a firm foundation of accurate awareness. You know the real deal and nothing will change your mind. This level of conviction will help you preserve through long, boring meetings and handle people who think they know it all. I know that's right. Lots of fast talk has been going on, but not a lot of progress. You'll suddenly see certain people in a much clearer light. All right, Scorpio. That's a good one. Scorpios are very smart and they're very blunt and don't have no problem with telling you about yourself. And Scorpios can be real, like, child, don't get caught up in that claw. They will not let you loose. They will hold a grudge forever. And I'm just only speaking on Scorpios, I know. But somebody told me that's because they were is a wonderful time in your life for a group project, group travel, and group socializing. Collaboration will be easy and everyone's flexibility is at an all-time high. The energy creates when you poses, get together, is positioned and supported, cook something up, toss out some ideas about where to go and what to do. Okay, that's Sagittarius. Yeah. And Capricorn. Oh, that was the last one. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the horoscope. Yeah. And I will see you in the next video. Bye, y'all. It's time to eat now. So join me. Let's eat. Join me. Come on over for dinner. Bye.
You're gonna feel out of day. We can tingle.